Welcome to Just Jesus. One life to live, one life to give. Hello friends, I'm Pastor Brian Park, and I want to welcome you to Listen Up, where we listen to the heart of God through the Word of God. Last time we explored the simple question, how can we avoid hell? Today, let's explore another simple question. What is born from above? Stay tuned. Many of us have heard this phrase, born again. It's such a familiar phrase, and when we hear this, we immediately think of a church-attending Christian. But what is born again? And is that right translation? We typically equate being born again as being exclusive to Christian experience, where a person meets Jesus and becomes a born-again Christian. But how do you communicate this important truth of becoming born again to someone if you cannot speak their language? Body language, of course. Then how do you describe born again? Much like rotating hand motions. For many Westerners, this body language of rotating hand motion may refer to being born again. But for many people in the East or other parts of the world, it may mean something completely different. It may look like you're trying to convey the idea of samsara, which is reincarnation theory, taught by Buddhism and Hinduism, where a person goes through repeated cycles of birth and rebirth, and birth and rebirth, and again and again. Then how can you avoid this confusion? Before we get into that, let me share with you several undeniable facts. It's an undeniable fact that we're all born and we'll all die. But what happens after you die? Do you just simply cease to exist? We had already addressed this and Listen Up 2, episode number 2. We're all created with the spirit, soul, and body, as 1 Thessalonians 5:23 tells us. Our body, which is formed from the dust of the ground, Genesis 2:7, will eventually go back to the earth. This is where the phrase ashes to ashes, dust to dust are often used at funeral, Genesis 3:19. However, your spirit and soul will exist forever. Whether you believe in Jesus or not, as long as you're a human being, your spirit and soul will exist for eternity. However, where you will spend your eternity will depend entirely on what you do on earth while living, not after you die. Those who put their trust in Jesus will die and live forever in heaven, while those who did not put their trust in Jesus will die and be tormented forever in hell. When you think about it, it's quite logical. Let's turn to the Bible for the answer. Genesis 2:7, the Lord God formed the man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being. After God formed man out of the dust of the ground, God breathed the breath of life into the man, and the man became a living being, a living soul with a fleshly body. The body, the flesh, is formed from the dust of the ground, and the body will eventually go back to earth where it came from. However, the spirit and soul did not come from the earth. It came from God, from above. And when you die, your flesh will return back to earth, but your spirit and soul, however, must return to where it came from, which is from God from above. Now, if you put your trust in Jesus, then God becomes your Father, and though your flesh will return to earth, your spirit and soul, however, will return back to your eternal home, which is heaven, where your heavenly Father awaits. However, If you didn't put your trust in Jesus while living, though you are created in God's image and His likeness, God is not your Father, and your flesh will return to earth, but your spirit and soul cannot return home. But instead, you will spend your eternity where your Father is not, which is hell. And I don't want to go there, and you don't want to go there, and God certainly doesn't want you to go there either. And this is what I already shared with you in Listen Up episode 4. Born once, die twice. Born twice, die once. If you're born of your parents but not born from above or born again, then when you die in person, you'll be raised from the grave to face judgment and eventual second death into the hell. Therefore, second death is the hell. However, if you're born of your parents and accept Jesus as your Savior and born from above or born again, then when you die in person, you will not die again, but live forever in heaven. Therefore, die only once and you will live forever in heaven with God. Therefore, once again, born once, die twice. Born twice, die once. Now, how is this possible? Just Jesus, of course. In chapter 3 of the book of John, it records conversation between Jesus and a man named Nicodemus. John 3 through 6. In reply, Jesus declared, "I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again." "How can a man be born when he's old?" Nicodemus asked. "Surely he cannot enter a second time into his mother's womb to be born." Jesus answered, "I tell you the truth, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit." The word Jesus said in Greek, recorded here, is anothen. Bible translates this word as born again, but the better translation of this Greek word, anothen, is actually born from above. And when you explain this important truth to someone with body motion, instead of rotating hand motion, which is born again, we can point up to heaven, which is born from above. And when you think about it, it makes perfect sense, doesn't it? Bible continues to tell us that a person who is born from above is someone who is, John 3:8, born of the Spirit. John 1:13, born of God. The moment you give your life to Jesus and begin to live for Jesus, then your identity is changed as a child of God, born of God, born of Spirit, and will eventually return home, which is heaven, where you will spend eternity with God in unending happiness. Hallelujah. Your identity is changed instantly from a person belonging to the world to a person belonging to God, as John 15:19 tells us, N-O-T-W, not of this world. Hallelujah. Those who are truly born from above can proudly proclaim that he or she no longer belongs to this world, but belongs to God. As such, our status is set apart and elevated as being N-O-T-W, not of this world. Our identity is confirmed and reaffirmed before God and before all the angels, and God will become your shield, your protector, your guide, your healer, your comforter, your king, your Lord, your Father, and he'll fight for you, he'll protect you, he'll provide for you, he'll heal you, will comfort you, and will bless you, and will set you apart from the world and eventually bring you back home where you will spend eternity with the Father. How is it possible? Really simple. Just Jesus. Surrender plus repentance equals restoration. Amen and hallelujah. Though your identity has changed as a born from above Christian, as long as you're on earth, you'll have troubles, problems, sicknesses, all kinds of unimaginable, even perhaps impossible situations. Then, as a child of God, born from above, born of God, born of Spirit, where then can you turn for help? The above, of course. Psalms 121. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. Friends, the Lord will keep you from all harms. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. Friends, in this life, you will have troubles. Why? Because we live in the enemy territory, behind the enemy line. Behind enemy line? I'll explain this someday. But one thing for sure, I guarantee you that you'll have troubles in life while living on earth. Just because you believe in Jesus, all your troubles will not somehow automatically disappear. However, instead of overcoming all your troubles on your own, with your own power, as a born from above child of God, you can now turn to the one who overcame all your troubles on the cross 2,000 years ago. Who, you might ask? Just Jesus, of course. Jesus already told us that you will have troubles on earth, but you and I have standing invitation from Jesus to turn to Him for everything, for He will help you to overcome all your troubles, and He truly does know and empathizes with you and your problems. Hebrews 4, 15 and 16. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to empathize with our weaknesses, but we have the one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet He did not sin. Let us then approach the God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need. Jesus is inviting us right now. John 16, 33. I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart. I have overcome the world. It's a given fact. We will all have troubles. Problems in this world because we live in the enemy territory. But take heart. Rather, do not lose heart. Do not worry. Do not try to overcome by your power, but turn to Jesus, for He had finished all this and more on the cross, and He's inviting us to turn to Him for all your troubles and all your problems, however big or small. Hebrews 4:14. Since we have a great high priest who has ascended into heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess. Now, that's what it means to become a born from above Christian. How amazing, how assuring is that? Then, how do you deal with your everyday problems as born from above Christian? And as someone who is N-O-T-W, not of this world? Philippians 4, 6 and 7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Simply, just Jesus, period. Now it's your turn. Pray you'll open your heart, give your life to Jesus, and begin to live for Jesus. And I promise you, He will shield and protect you. He'll fight for you, heal and comfort you, and guide you to heaven. For He alone can keep you from all the troubles on earth. Jesus is waiting for you. Friends, will you just open your heart and will you just trust Jesus? Thank you for listening to the Heart of God. And I would like to lead you to a simple prayer. Would you repeat after me? Precious Father, thank you for providing the way, your only begotten Son, Jesus, to come to you, to go to heaven. Now that I know the truth, I choose to hold firmly unto the truth, which is Jesus. From this moment on, I choose to open my heart before you. I choose to surrender before you. I choose to exalt Jesus as my only Lord and my Savior. And I choose to repent of all my wrongdoings. And I choose to follow you for all the days of my life. Precious Father, please accept me as your child. Please forgive me of all my wrongs. And please help me to live a brand new life as a born from above Christian, not of this world. And help me to enjoy all your goodness and eventually go to heaven. Thank you for giving me this amazing opportunity to exalt you as my Lord an amazing privilege to be called your child. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Listen, Up is found on Just Jesus channel on YouTube, and I would invite you all to grow together as we listen to the heart of God through the word of God. Everyone, thank you. We love you. We'll see you next time, and God bless you. Are the sun, and I'm your